God bless you out there. Hello there, YouTube land. North America, South America, Africa, Europe, Middle East, Far East. For the glory be to God. New prophecy from the throne room. Prophecy on white horse prophecy. Here it is, the white horse prophecy. That prophecy was given in 1843 by the founder of the Mormon Church, Joseph Smith, in Nauvoo, Illinois. And one night, I was talking to my beloved number one daughter, Miss Alicia Culley, and I said, white horse prophecy. We felt the power of God. We felt His anointing like from the throne room. The search come. I never felt nothing like that. From the crown of her head to soles of feet, this prophecy is being fulfilled in 2012. We just felt like we stuck our hand in the throne room for God, just like in a 220. We got spiritual presence of God. He is Lord Jesus, the Savior and Messiah. This prophecy is being fulfilled in 2012 right here. It's 169 years old, and God gave this to me in 18 minutes. I'm going to read it here. Prophecy on white horse prophecy. In 1843, Mormon Joseph Smith gave the white horse prophecy in Nauvoo, Illinois. The prophecy was about the Mormon people going to Salt Lake City, Utah from Illinois. That is what the Rocky Mountains is about. In the prophecy, Joseph Smith couldn't go. The prophecy is 169 years old today. Also, the prophecy said the U.S. Constitution is hanging by a thread. That is what's happening to the U.S. Constitution in 2012. The White Horse prophecy is about Mormon Mitt Romney running against Barack Obama for President of the United States. The election will be close, but Muslim Obama will win. In 1844, 1 year later, Joseph Smith was killed in a jail in Carthage, Illinois. Lots of people didn't know that Mormon Joseph Smith was running for a third party for President of the United States. The Illinois people didn't like Joseph Smith because he was a Mormon, and he got killed because the Illinois people didn't want him to run for the President of the United States of America. The missing link of the White Horse prophecy is the White House election in 2012. And may God have had His blessings upon His holy word, His prophetic word. This is a prophecy. This is prophecy on a white horse prophecy. We're seeing this be fulfilled, that Joseph Smith got killed in 1844. He couldn't run for President of the United States. He was the founder of Mormon Church, but Mitt Romney is a Mormon, and his prophecy is being fulfilled later, 169 years later. He's running for President of the United States in year 2012. So it'll be a close election. But President Obama is the Antichrist. He will not lose this election. He is a Muslim. It will be going down to the wire. It'll be a horse race right till the end. It's right now, you know, it's going to be one of the closest races in the history of the United States of America. So that's from the throne room today. And this is your time. There's not much time left. Jesus returning soon. And turn your life over to Jesus Christ. This be your grace decision. You know, the election is going to be on November the 6th, 2012. And today is October 23rd, 2012. We're only talking 14 more days. And the number 14 in God's number is deliverance. And this election, all global eyes is upon this election. And this be the greatest election in the history of the United States of America. And this is your time. This is your hour. If you don't know Jesus Christ as your personal Savior all over the world, turn your life over to the Lord. This is the destiny for Jesus Christ wants you to be saved. He died on the cross on Golgotha on Calvary. He had to die so we could live eternal life with Him. This is your time to turn your life over to Jesus Christ. Confess with your mouth and believe in your heart. Say this prayer with me, and Jesus will save your soul right today. Today is the day of salvation. Lord Jesus Christ, I am a sinner. Lord Jesus Christ, I repent of my wicked ways. Lord Jesus Christ, Thank you for forgiving me for my sin, Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you for saving my soul, Lord Jesus Christ. My name's written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ. I have eternal life in heaven with you, God and Jesus, forever and ever. You said that prayer, right, George and Betty Culley, Lisa Brother Ministries, you know, right there in Pinckneyville, 407 South Douglas, Pinckneyville, Illinois, 62274. We thank you, YouTube, today, putting this video on our profile page on YouTube channel, on George and Betty Culley's channel. There is our address. There is an email. Give us the good news that you said to Jesus Christ, your greatest decision in your life. And me and Betty Culley and Lisa Culley will be praying for you, and Lisa Brother Ministries in Pinckneyville, Illinois. We love you. Most important, Jesus loves you. Just keep your eyes on Jesus. He's returning soon. There's not much time left. Jesus controlled the whole wide world in his hands. He's in control. He allows the things that happen in the White House. But Jesus Christ is in control, for the glory be to God. Amen, amen.